Hi guys, and welcome to video 25 in the But How to With No Companion video series. Now in the last two videos, we learned about microcode and also about shift registers. And today we're going to see how we're going to be using these two technologies to complete our control section down here. To begin, let's briefly look at how we are going to implement the microcode and also go over a simplified version of the code running in the control unit. We start by defining binary constants for each of the control signals in our CPU. The binary values correspond to the positions of the different signals in the control section. Then we define a large array of 32-bit values. In the Arduino, we use unsigned long type for this. We initialize the array with all the different combinations of control signals required. The keyword progmem on line 1 is what indicates that we wish to store this table in the flash memory of the Arduino. Next to each entry number, you can see the formula that is used to locate an entry in the table, followed by the details for the current line. So to locate a line in the microcode table, you take the current instruction and convert it to a decimal value. Then multiply it by 6, add 2 times the current step minus 4, and finally add 0 to get the enable signals or 1 to get the set signals. The entries for the add instruction that we looked at in video number 23 start at entry 774. You can see that the control signals to activate are the same ones as the ones we had in our truth table. Now let's look at the loop function for the control unit. It receives from the clock and stepper the clock E and clock S signals as well as the current step. We start by initializing our control word to 0. Then, if click E or click S are on, we enter the switch statement. The first 3 cases are used to set the control signals for steps 1, 2, and 3. These are identical for each instruction. So by doing this, we cut our microcode size in half. Steps 4, 5, and 6 are handled by the default block. We start by getting the value in the IR. Then we use it to calculate the address in the microcode table using the formula we saw before. Next, if click E is on, we get the microcode entry for it, and we do the same thing if click S is also on. The PGM read DWORD function is used to read data from flash memory. Finally, we send the control word value to a function called writeCW. The writeCW function simply calls the proper Arduino functions to send the control word value to our chain of shift registers. Let's take a look at this schematic showing what we're going to be adding to our project board. Here is the best way to build this section. First, remove all the 10k ohm resistors from the bottom of the control section. We will not be needing those anymore. Add the wiring for the 3 new control signals, 2 blue ones in the second section, and 1 yellow one in the fourth section. Add all the short black wires that will provide the ground connections for our LEDs. Add all the LEDs and the 1K resistors that go with each of them. Next, install the SN74HC595 chips and connect all the power and ground signals required. Connect the outputs of all the shift registers to the proper control signals. This part is a bit tricky. Make sure you look at the schematic properly to make sure you get the connections right. Finally, connect the first shift register to the Arduino using the white wires, and then create the shift register daisy chain as shown. So let's go see what this looks like once it's completed. So this is what the control section looks like once we finished assembling it. Let's turn the power on. So you could see that all the LEDs turn on during the power on reset, but then once the clock initializes itself properly, you can see that clock E and clock S are both off, so the control word gets initialized to all zeros. Now the clock is waiting for us to press the button to advance it. Now to test this, this is exactly what we need to do. Start the clock and start processing instructions. However, we did not input a program into our computer yet, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing in the next video. See you soon!
Thank you.